Hello! Hello, boys and girls!
Hi, everyone!
It's good to see all of you today. Thank you for tuning in for our lessons today. I'm sure today you will be blessed. My name is Apple.
Apple?
Yes, and you are?
My name is Ore.
Is that your real name?
Yeah.
That is our names for today. So before we continue, we want to pray. Let us pray.
Dear Heavenly Father, as we come before you, Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the wisdom and the knowledge and understanding that you've given unto us, O Lord. As we begin this show, we pray, O Lord, that you may guide us and that you may be with us all through. In Jesus' name, I do pray and believe.
Amen. Indeed and amen. I believe you're there and you're wondering, how comes Teacher Esther today is an apple and Teacher Brian is an
orange?
Orange. I believe you're wondering. But today we are just talking about the love of God. And today it's all about the love and the joy of the Lord. I believe the Lord is going to give us a lot of love and even a lot of joy in our hearts as we do our lesson for today about the fruit of the
Holy Spirit.
Oh yes. And boys and girls, right about now is our time for JH Connect.
Number one, get ready with your Bibles.
And number two, get ready with your notebook.
And number three, get ready with your pen.
Number four, I want you to listen very carefully. Get some space. You know why? Because number five,
it's time to dance for Jesus.
Yay.
Shine, let it shine. Hi, boys and girls. Guess what time it is? It's dance time. So stand up and let's dance together.
Ho! Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life. Back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be?
Wow, I hope you enjoyed the dance and washing.
I did.
Did you enjoy?
I have really enjoyed and have learned a move today.
Nice. Yes, wonderful, yes. Wonderful, wonderful.
And I believe you have also enjoyed our praise and worship. Uh-huh. That was amazing, amazing, amazing. It's good to worship our God.
Yeah.
So he's very, the living God. Eh?
Very important.
And all our worship we should give to Jesus Christ. Uh-huh. And right about now, we are getting ready and ready and ready. Guess what for? For JH
Game Challenge.
Hello, boys and girls. My name is Deborah, and guess what time it is? It's the JH Game Challenge. So with me today, I have Teacher Anne and Teacher Gladys. So our activity today is about these nicely colored beads and these six plastic cups. So each teacher has three plastic cups, and they get to choose three colors of their choice. And the rule of the game is you only have to pick one bead at a time. Yes. So we have 1 minute to see who makes it. And it starts now. And stop. So we'll start by counting Teacher Gladys's beads. And we see she has green, blue, and colorless. So let's count the green ones first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So she has 19 green beads. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 blue beads. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So she has 19 green beads, 15 blue beads, and 11 colorless beads. So in total, she has 45. So we put this aside. Let's go to Teacher Anne's own bead. She has blue, green, and orange. So we start with the blue ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Wow, 22 blue beads. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 green beads. And 1, 2, 3 orange beads. So we can already tell the winner. Shaan has 35 beads and Teacher Gladys has 45 beads. So our winner is Teacher Gladys. So we have come to the end of our activity. Until next time, kids, bye.
My name is Steven and I have a memory verse. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, it says, God wants everyone to be saved and to know the whole truth. Thank you.
My name is Nara Modone and I have a memory verse. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, it says, God wants everybody to be saved and to know the whole truth. Thank you.
1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, it says, God wants everyone to be saved and to know the whole truth.
1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, it says, God wants everyone to be saved and to know the whole truth.
1 Timothy 2 verse 4, it says, God wants everyone to be saved and to know the whole truth.
1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, it says, God wants everyone to be saved and to know the whole truth. 1
Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, it says, God wants us to be saved and to know the whole truth. Thank you.
Oh! Did you see that game challenge?
It was hard today. Yeah? It was very, very hard. I can't imagine taking those small, small beads and taking even the colors. Mm. Hey, I don't know. Today was very, very hard.
I saw some teacher. It's like they were colorblind.
Oh, they were colorblind. Oh, my God. Yeah. And you know, even if it was very hard, we had a winner for today.
Yeah, they really did
a good job.
Kabisa.
And boys and girls, it is so good to see that you can remember what we have been learning. And some of you can even do the memory verse. That is very, very good.
Keep it up.
Oh, yes. Keep it up, keep it up.
Yeah.
And now, to learn more about the fruit of the Spirit, we are going to do our Bible story. And I want you to help us welcome our Bible story teacher. Who is?
Teacher Joa.
Oh, yes. Welcome.
Hello, boys and girls. How are you and how was your week? Are you excited for our Bible lesson for today? I have missed you and I'm glad to be back. My name is Teacher Joanne and I'll be taking you through our lesson for today. So I hope you're ready. Are you ready? Mm-hmm. I know you're wondering, what is this plant doing here? So today our lesson is about the fruit of the Holy Spirit. And our Bible reading comes from Galatians chapter 5, from verse 22 up to 23. And today I have got two stories for you. And I hope you're going to be attentive and listen and learn something from our Bible lesson for today. So the Bible tells us that the fruit of the Holy Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And today, we are going to learn about two fruits of the Holy Spirit, which is love and joy. And before we learn about the fruit of love and the fruit of joy, I want us to see what will happen. I want us to learn about this plant. Just like a farmer goes to the garden, he plants some seeds. And when he plants these seeds, what happens? It rains and the plant starts growing. And when it grows, it produces some fruit, like this tomato fruit or plant. It has produced some fruit. So when we get born again and we walk with Jesus and we invite the Holy Spirit into our lives, as believers, we must produce some fruits. And these fruits help us to grow in the things of God. Have you learned? Yes, we have to grow in the things of God. And so today we are learning how, as a Christian, we are going to produce some fruits when the Holy Spirit is upon us. And today we are learning about two fruits, love and joy. The Bible tells us that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish and have everlasting life. Why? God gave his Son Jesus to us because he loved us. And there is a story told, not in the Bible, but in a storybook, about a man who was a driver of a school. And he was the school bus driver. And he had a son. So one day, he entered the bus, and the children entered the bus, and he was driving along the road. He used to drive every day outside his house, and he used to pass his boy. Every time he used to pass by, the boy used to come out of the house and greet his father and say bye to him. So one day, as he was going down, the house of the school driver of the bus was downhill. And so, as he was going downhill with the bus, guess what happened? The brakes of the bus failed. And now he was carrying some children inside the bus. And he was wondering, what am I going to do? This bus is going to crash with all the children inside. And as he was going down, he said, I'm going to hit my son because I'm going to pass him down there, down the hill. What am I going to do? Am I going to crash with the children in the bus? Or am I going to hit my son? Do you know what happened? If it was you, what would have you done? The school bus driver tried to brake, but the brakes failed. So he decided that as he goes down the hill and the bus was going so fast, he went and hit the gate of his house. And guess what? The son was standing near the gate and he died. That is the same way that God did. He sacrificed his son Jesus to die for us, to save us, because he loved us. And that is the love of God. And that is the same way us as believers, we are supposed to produce the fruit of love. Yes, we are supposed to have the fruit of love so that when we have love inside of us, we are able to share the word of God and to share the love of Jesus with the people that are around us. Have you gotten it? Yes, I hope you are learning something. And now for the fruit of joy. There is a story in the Bible told about Paul and Silas. And Paul was a disciple of Jesus. And he went about preaching the word of God into Judea, into Samaria, into Jerusalem. And this time he went to Rome to preach the word of God. And when he was there in Rome preaching the word of God with Silas, guess what happened? As he was preaching, he met a girl who was possessed with a demon, a bad spirit. And Paul cast out the demon, and that girl was saved, and she became a believer, and she started following Paul and following the teachings of Jesus. And do you know what happened? People in Rome, they started telling about Paul and Silas, what they were doing, preaching the word of God, and they went and reported them to the authorities in Rome. And do you know what happened? They were captured and they were put into prison. And when they were in prison, is prison a good place? It is not a good place. It is a bad place. Nobody would want to go to prison. But guess what? When Paul and Silas were in prison, they were not sad because they had the joy of God inside of them. They had the fruit of joy in them. And when they were in prison with Silas, Paul and Silas, they started praising Jesus. They started singing and worshiping God. They were saying, I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart, because they had the joy of the Lord. Even when they were in a bad situation, they still worshiped and they still praised God. And so, even you and me, we are supposed to have the joy, the fruit of joy in us, even when we have bad situations. No matter what we are going through, no matter what storms, we are supposed to have the love and the joy of the fruit of the Spirit inside of us. So as we grow in Jesus, as we walk in Jesus, these fruits are supposed to be in us. And how they're in us is because we have the Holy Spirit. You remember we learned that the Holy Spirit is our helper? Yes, when we have the Holy Spirit, these fruits are supposed to be in us and we are able to produce good fruits. And the assignment for this week, I want you to draw a tree. Can you see my tree? Yes, I want you to draw a tree. And this tree represents our lives. And we are going to draw the fruit of love. And we are going to draw the fruit of joy, so that it can remind us that we are supposed to produce these fruits of the Holy Spirit. That is love and joy. And every week, we are going to be putting all the fruits that we have learned from Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. So draw a big tree. So every week, you are going to be drawing the fruit that you have learned for the week. And if you have not given your life to Jesus, you cannot be able to produce any fruit if you don't have Jesus in your life. And I want us to make a prayer. Yes, I want us to make a prayer for us to invite Jesus so that when we have the Holy Spirit, we are able to produce good fruits. Are you ready to pray? Repeat after me. Lord Jesus, I come before you. I am a sinner. I have sinned before you. I ask for your forgiveness. Come into my heart. Be the Lord and my Savior and the Savior of my life. I want you to lead me. I want you to guide me. And I want you to fill me with the fruit of the Holy Spirit that I may walk in the right path. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you have made that prayer, you are born again. And now you shall invite the Holy Spirit to come and be with you and be your helper. And I hope you have enjoyed our lesson for today. Remember, we have learned about the fruit of the Holy Spirit. See you next week. Bye.
How was the Bible story?
The Bible story today was amazing, amazing. I have actually learned that you cannot bear the fruit of the Spirit if you have not invited Jesus in your heart.
And also, did you hear the story that Chajoan gave?
Oh, yes.
About the bus driver?
Yes, it
was awesome. And I'm really humbled by the bus driver.
Yes.
He really loved those children.
Oh, yes. And he did just like Jesus would do. Mm. And that is the love of Jesus.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. I believe we are going to have the joy of the Lord and the love of God. And we are going to share with people. That is when love is felt, when you share. Don't keep it to yourself. Don't keep joy to yourself. Share it around. Yeah. And now we want to welcome some boys and girls for our...
Hi, the word.
I am 7 years old and I have a memory. Galatians chapter 5 verse 22-23, it says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Thank you.
Hi guys, I have a good memory verse. And today memory verse is
Galatians 5:22-23. It says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law.
Galatians 5:22-23, it says, for the fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things is no law.
Hi, my name is Ryan Akwemba from ages 10 to 12, and I'll be presenting to you a memory verse. Galatians 5:22-23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control. Against such things, there is no law.
Galatians 5:22-23, it says, but the fruits of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful. Did you see your children?
Oh yes, they are doing an amazing, amazing job. And boys and girls, continue doing. We continue with the same spirit.
Yeah.
You can actually recite the memory verse and do it even at your home. Mm-hmm. You can recite it even to your friends and even to your parents, right?
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
They can do that.
And also, don't forget about the assignment that Teacher Joan gave you.
Oh yes.
Grow the big tree and put... And also grow the fruits.
Oh yes.
The fruit
of the Holy Spirit
of love and the fruit of joy.
And stick it to that tree.
Yeah,
yes.
And show your parents, show your friends, yes. Share it. You can also take a photo of it and share it with your friends at home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And they'll be so glad to see that work. And now we want to pray. We want to thank God for keeping us and giving us a wonderful show, right?
Yeah.
It's been amazing.
Yeah,
you
true.
Look excited. You look like you have the joy of the Lord.
Yeah, I'm joyful.
Oh, yes. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we want to thank you. We want to give you praise, Jehovah Lord. Thank you for the lessons that we have had today, Jehovah. We pray that even as we start a new week, that the joy of the Lord, that the love of God will be part of our lives, oh God. May we be a much fruit, Jesus, even as we continue learning more about who you are, Jehovah. We bless your holy name and we exalt your holy name, oh God. Bless our teachers and bless our parents, bless even our nation. We give you praise. Because you be with us, oh Lord. We bless you, we worship you, and we honor your holy name. And it is in Jesus' mighty name that we pray and we give thanks.
Amen.
That was wonderful having you around, and we pray that the Lord will keep you. So until next time,
bye.